Hey, what's up, peeps? My name is Lachlan Monroe. You're watching Vinny and Skip on the best damn movie show on YouTube.com.
Hey, welcome back, fans. The best damn movie show, the show that never ends, that we always keep on rolling. Well, last night we went to go see Danny Collins starring Al Pacino. I do not know, folks, when you're going to see this movie. There's no release date on it. So, all our friends out there, if you went and got to see Home, I'm very sorry about your luck, but you made the bad decision without picking Mr. Collins.
Yeah, what a just fantastic movie. Danny Collins, played by Al Pacino, reminds me, you know, I told you.
I mean, just a poster alone behind us, just a poster alone, I mean, could sell the movie.
Yeah, you put those names, look. Bobby Cannavale, Jennifer Garner, Annette Bening, Christopher Plummer, and the tip of the iceberg, Mr. Al Pacino. If he doesn't give the performance of the year so far, in my opinion, this movie flops and dies and goes into the trash. But it's because of his acting ability and this Oscar winner for Scent of a Woman, four-time Oscar nominee, gives the performance of the year. I mean, I've seen, I don't know, 35 movies this year so far. This is the performance of the year. Yes, it's early in the year, but I love the fact that the best actor, one of the best actors on the planet, gives the best acting performance of the year. And he's kind of been phoning in his performances the last few years. You know, with Jack and Jill, The Humbling wasn't that
good. Well, yeah, I mean, The Humbling, like you said, it's a kind of a kickoff of
takeoff, yeah.
Birdman without all the special effects. I wasn't too big of a fan, and that kind of gave me my decision as how Danny Collins is going to be. But I tell you what, I took my mom and dad with us to go see Danny Collins, and my dad loved Danny Collins. I mean, it kind of reminded him of himself back in his day, and Danny Collins might, because they're. It just shows you what kind of decisions you make in your life, and how a certain thing or a certain person that comes along in your way makes you change and think about how to change your ways.
Yeah, he gets his letter. This letter, without giving a, he gets his letter, and he decides to change what he's doing, change his whole entire life, and go to New Jersey, and then he meets some people and some people that he wouldn't have met because he stayed. He lived in L.A. The movie starts with him at the Greek Theater singing, and people love him, and he's this big kind of Tony Bennett kind of Neil Diamond type of singer.
But it's about a semi-true story about a folk singer named Steve Knowlton.
No.
Was it Knowlton?
No. Hickson?
Hickson, sorry. Steve Hickson.
Yeah, but I mean, Annette Bening, Jennifer Garner, Bobby Cannavale, Christopher Plummer. I mean, they all give great performances as a supporting cast. I mean, what a top-notch cast Dan Fogelman put together for this movie. Me and you had talked about it. This is probably one of the best movies, if not the best movie I've seen all year. Next, maybe The Kingsman up till this point. I'd say The Kingsman.
I think this is a little better than The Kingsman.
It might be. The more I think about it, I might put it above The Kingsman as my number one movie of the year so far right now.
You got this movie, Danny Collins, and you got Home, which comes out Friday. And we could have had a choice of either one, you know, but we decided to go to the Cobb Theater in Orlando. If you've not been to Cobb Theater in Orlando,
wow.
It's an amazing place to go see a movie. Great food.
It's definitely
very comfortable seats. The parking's not that great down there, which, you know, there's one thing, and the food's a little expensive, more so than your Winter Park, your Altamont, things like that. But hey, take it for us. We just got a bucket of popcorn, a couple beers, watch the movie. And you come and you go out and you get something to eat later on, you know? You don't have to spend a whole $30 taking the family out for a movie or things like that. But Danny Collins was worth it. It was worth the drive. And this movie was not a screener. We had to pay for it. And it was a special movie because there's no release date on it. I mean, Al Pacino is doing a bunch of press for it. He's been on Good Morning America, Today Show, and what was that name? Charlie Rose. He was on that show promoting the movie. I wouldn't be surprised if he's on Jimmy Fallon this week sometime. If not, has already been, because I haven't really been caught up. I'm gonna give my third 10 out of 10 for Danny Collins.
Yeah, I cannot say enough about what an amazing performance that headlines this cast, that makes this movie go. I mean, this kind of old, you know, he's in his 50s, late 50s, early 60s, whatever, singer who's lived a life of fame and fortune, and, you know, he decides to do something crazy, and I think it's just such a great heartfelt. There's some subplots in the movie with some of the characters that are very, very interesting subplots. You know, I give this the highest I could say. It's a big see it for me, because I urge you, if there's any way you could see this movie, please do yourself a favor and see Danny Collins, Al Pacino at his best.
And I also got to check out on demand The Cobbler, starring Adam Sandler, Steve Buscemi. I don't know when it's going to be released. I know you can buy it on, like,
on demand. I know Amazon.
A couple on demand things are doing. They're selling it. You can rent it, but no, you know, physical actual release date to buy it, or, you know. But what The Cobbler is Adam Sandler plays a shoe repair man taking over the business from his father. And Steve Buscemi is a neighbor who owns a barbershop next to him. And Redman, you know, the rapper Redman, comes in and drops off a pair of shoes and says he wants them fixed by the end of the day. Well, the shoes have powers and turns them into people and different characters, and it's a ride. It's kind of like Rain on Me. It's a little darker, Adam Sandler, gloomier. It's worth the watch. It's not a typical Adam Sandler film. The next Adam Sandler film that actually hits theaters is Pixels. You know, with all the characters from all the 80s video games. But The Cobbler, I'll give it a 6 out of 10. I don't think it was, it's worth the watch, but it's not, it's one of those Adam Sandler films, because a lot of people think that, like, you know, a lot of people think that some of his other things that he's done, some of his latest, like That's My Boy, and what's the one with the twins?
Back in Jail.
They didn't like those. And see, I like those, because I think they're stupid funny. They have a laugh. You know, Rain Over Me, Punch Drunk Love, and The Cobbler, they have no, there's some laughs, but very little. And that's why I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10. Well, hey, listen, when we come back, with the best movie show, we're going to get into some movie news. So stick around.